Good evening.
Good evening.
We're gathered here on this evening for a celebration of life. And what I mean by a celebration of life, and that's exactly what it is. The thing about Amanda is she knew the Lord Jesus. And we have a promise that after this life is over, then the real good life begins. Amanda had some hard times, but she lived through them. She's now, somebody said, when you leave from this life, you go to a better place. Well, that's only half true. You go to a far better place. And that's what every one of us have to look forward to when we call on the name of the Lord. So if you just want to take time and let yourself remember, reflecting on her life and how she influenced you, truly everybody in here right now has a memory, has a thought. Meditate on that right now. Every one of you in here is her legacy. It's not what you take with you when you go. It's what you leave behind. That's the true treasure of anybody's life. And as I'm looking out here, you are the treasure of her life. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, as we're gathered in this place this evening to honor, to remember, and to reflect on Amanda's life, we thank you for the opportunity we had to know her and how she did influence our lives. And Father, we know that when one departs from this life, it just seems so like an end, but it's really not the end. It's a continuation. And Lord, we thank you that she's in your hands right now. And we give you all the glory, all the praise, and all the honor for it. Now may the Spirit of the living God comfort those who mourn, and may he give you peace that passes all understanding. We pray this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God's people said amen.
Amen.
Amanda McClain. Born on September the 3rd, 1988, she departed this life at her home on September the 26th, 2023, losing a battle to a long-term illness. You know, the truth of it is, ladies and gentlemen, on September the 26th, she changed her address. Amen. From the natural earth to the supernatural heavenly realm. I don't know, perhaps her new address is 777 Hallelujah Highway, I don't know. But I'm sure that one day we'll know when we get there. Because the Lord himself says that he is up there right now, preparing a place for each and every one who has called upon that name of Jesus. Amen. She was born in Ridgeway, Pennsylvania, the daughter of Keith Ben Orsdale, Catherine Flouser, Zelensky, Jack. On August 12, 2017, she married the love of her life. Tim, you may smile.
She made me smile a lot.
She made you smile a lot. Timothy C. McClain of Ridgeway survives. Amanda attended Ridgeway High School and went on to develop her entrepreneurial spirit at a variety of small endeavors. Many of them were featured online, as well as local craft stores. She was a co-owner of Lazy River Canoe Rentals alongside her loving husband, Tim. The two of them had many family adventures. Amanda loved her family deeply and had a passion for sharing her creativity online with her auctions. She loved to shop at all events she attended.
That's
an
understatement.
Everybody said amen. She was a natural talent at the bass guitar. There it is. It's not exactly purple, but it's close enough.
She hated it.
She hated it. Okay. All right. So I think she doesn't want to really, really much right now. Okay, she was a natural talent at the bass guitar and was a member of my musical romance band with her family and friends, who have been entertaining the music community of Ridgewood and beyond for 2 years. She, along with her husband, was instrumental in bringing the River Fest to Ridgewood in memory of Tom Dickinson for the past 3 years. Amanda loved animals, especially her dog, Finnegan. And you know what, as you're sitting out there, I'm up here talking, you know, the thing of it is, she's a personality that you're not going to forget. Yeah. You know, and how she endeavored to endure impresses me. I know, and you know, that we're living in a world that's not friendly. But we're living in a world that if you know who Jesus Christ is, you ultimately overcome. A lot of people look at our departure from this life as the end, but it's not the end. It's a continuation. And there's a far better place that lies beyond. See, we're gathered here, and we're remembering Amanda and her life. The tribulations, the trials that she went through, and she went through some, but you know what? She came out victorious. It wasn't that long-term illness that took her down. You know what it was? It was her faith in the Lord Jesus Christ on the hereafter. I believe that with all my heart. Even though she went through some trials in her life, during the end of her life, she knew. She came to a knowledge that a lot of people never come to. She came to the knowledge that when this life was through, there was something better waiting for her. And I think every one of us knows that. We're here and we're mourning, but you know what? She's not mourning right now. But I'll tell you what, we're on her minds. As she's on our minds. I just have a couple of scriptures I want to read to you. And God's word is true, and it cannot be broken. God's word is everlasting. In John chapter 11, verse 25, Jesus said this, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he be dead, yet shall he live." And then he goes on to say, "And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Do you believe this? And this is where our faith stands out. Believing that the word of God is absolutely true. John chapter 14, beginning at verse 1, reads like this. And these are promises made to each and every one of us who have called upon the name of the Lord. "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you." Do you know He's preparing a place for each and every one of us? At that appointed time when we arrive in His presence. "And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know." And Thomas, one of his disciples, said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? And Jesus said this, I am the way, the truth, the life. When he said that, he said, no man comes to the Father except through me. That is something I'm going to do. You know, absent from the body, present with the Lord. And I want you to think on that and hang on to that thought, because it's the truth. And now I want to read to you something that's about to happen. I believe this is going to happen. It could happen before we're out of this building tonight. And it's found in 1 Thessalonians in chapter 4, beginning of verse 13, reads like this. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brother, according to concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who are asleep in him. And that's where a man is right now. She is asleep in him. She's departed her body. She wore that thing out. And now she has, in the presence of God, a spirit body. Oh, she's walking, she's moving, she's breathing, she's talking. But she's in a whole different realm. A realm that one of these days you and I are going to figure that out too. For all who call on the name of the Lord. Verse 15. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, the trumpet of God, the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord. Verse 18 says, therefore comfort one another with these words. These should be comforting words, because this will happen. And if you believe what's going on in the world today, it might not be that far off. God's going to say amen.
Amen.
Makes it easier on us, but we still miss her. She was instrumental in our band. Matt weaseled out one of her favorite bass guitars, but not really. She was very happy that Matt was playing, and he filled in for us when she was sick. And so we just thought it would be a nice tribute to do a few songs that she liked. Couple of gospel tunes, but we probably won't do that. Anyway, but so we're gonna do so Joel started playing violin about a year and a half ago, and we were at Smoke Country Jam with some friends, Bluegrass Festival, and we come up with this great name, Ruby. She's Ruby. And we are the Mountain Gems for her. So we're gonna do a old tune. It's called Where Will This Circle Be Unbroken?
I'm
Philippians in chapter 3. chapter 3, and I just want to expound on this because it's so encouraging to know what happens after this life. You know, the Bible says that when you depart from this life, you join what is called a cloud of witnesses. And a cloud of witnesses is somebody who watches. I always likened it to like a football game or a baseball game. You got the players in the field, but then you got all the people that are in the bleachers. They're witnesses. And somehow, I just believe that somehow, that those who have gone before us, it is possible for them to witness what we're doing now. And I think that's not only possible, but I think that's scriptural. So I'm going to read this to you, Philippians in chapter 3, and beginning at verse 20. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly body, that it may be conformed to his glorious body, according to that which is working in each and every one of us. He is able to subdue all things unto himself. You see, the thing you're living in right now is temporal. I don't know if you know that or not. It gets old. But the thing of it is, the Bible says the outward man perishes, but the inward man is renewed day by day. And because the inward man is renewed day by day, that means life will go on. It may not go on in your earthly body, but it's going to go on in the kingdom of heaven. As a matter of fact, in 2 Corinthians, I'll read this one to you also. 2 Corinthians in chapter 5, verse 1 is written this way. For we know that if our earthly house, this tent, that's your body, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house, not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan, earnestly desiring to be clothed with our habitation, which is from heaven. If indeed, having been clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we who are in this tent groan, being burdened, not because we want to be unclothed, but further clothed, that morality may be swallowed up of life. Now he who has prepared us for this very thing is God, who also has given us the Spirit as a guarantee, so that we are always confident, knowing that while we are home at the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. For we are confident, yes, well pleased, rather, to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. What a promise. And one day, each and every one of us is going to have that awesome travel. Once you know, as I believe Amanda knew, once you know, this is not the end. But for a lot of folks, it's the end of the suffering, it's the end of pain. And I'll tell you what, you can enter into the glory. But to think of it is, ladies and gentlemen, each and every one of us have our own path to walk. We need to walk it out. And as we walk it out, we remember those who have gone before us. Not that we say goodbye, but that we say we'll see you later. Because that's the truth. We will see them later. Because the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, the trumpet of God, the dead in Christ shall rise first, and us who are alive and remain shall be changed. That's going to happen. Even though a lot of people think it won't happen, God says it will. And guess who I believe? I believe the one that made us. God created us. We're the creation. And sometimes the creation tells the creator he's not right. That just doesn't seem to be right. I want to tell you, friends, in this place, as we're celebrating Amanda's life, think about where she is now. You know, the Word of God tells us in 1 Corinthians 13, it says, now we look in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now we know in part, but then we're going to know even as we're knowing. I was asked by a fellow one time, he said, when we get there, you think we're going to know one another? And I said, if you know me now, you're going to know me then. The only difference, I believe, I'll be a lot better with. Because the body that the Lord has stored up for us is perfect. It's perfect. The man is in a place where there's no more pain. No more heartache. No more shame. No more death. God makes everything new. And that's exactly what's happening. Why are we here? Celebrate. Celebrate. You know what that means? Now I gotta answer that question. What it means to celebrate is simply this. She ran her race, she fought the fight, she kept the faith, and now there's laid up for her a crown of glory in heaven, and the Lord himself placed it on her hand. That's the truth. And that's what we know. Because that's what the Bible tells us. And all of God's people said amen.
Amen.
See that?
Just a difficult time to get through for us. I didn't know how I was going to do this. This might seem kind of strange. But this is what we did as a family, with our friends. And it just kind of seemed appropriate. So we're probably going to do two songs, and then that'll be it for us. So we hope you like them. We're playing stuff that Amanda liked. I think she liked them, didn't she, Joe? Okay. Sometimes it was hard to tell.
Thank you.
There's an old Bill Monroe song. I never thought I'd be in the house of death.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Amanda Nell's daughter, she's 11. Hey, Jocelyn, come up here, Jocelyn. Please, come up here. Come on, Lori, I'll come up with you. Come up here. Quickly. So these are our girls. This is Jocelyn. These are our girls. And this is what I have for the rest of my life to remember my wife. And I'm so grateful. So grateful.
Out of this world the soul of our sister. We therefore commit her body to the ground, that earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Looking for the resurrection at the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, at whose coming to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead. The bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed, be made likened unto his glorious body, according to that power by which he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Could you join me in the Lord's prayer, please? Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and glory forever. Amen.
Almighty God, we are gathered at this place today to lay to rest the body of our friend, our loved one, whom we will miss, but will be joined again. We do so remembering another grave and another place and another time, the tomb that received the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. As Jesus came from the grave to live again, we know that all who die in him shall never truly die. Help us, Father, to walk by faith, not by sight, for our trust is in him who said, do not be afraid, I am the first and the last, I am the living one, I was dead, and behold, I am alive forever and ever, and I hold the keys of death and of Hades. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, all God's people.
Amen.
And may God bless you. And may he keep you safe and sound, and certainly heaven bound. And may walk out your life in the faith that Jesus died 2,000 years ago on the cross to give us access to the kingdom of heaven. May the peace of Christ that passes all understanding rest upon each and every one of you, as you continue fellowshipping in this place, and as you break bread together and share your memories and your stories with one another. God bless you all. And to all, a good night.
Amen.
Amen. Bless what you're going to drink and eat back here. Bless the food and the drink. Bless and sanctify the holy unto us who partake of by faith in Jesus' name. God's people said,
amen.
Amen. God bless you all. And this was a memorial to remember. Amen. Thank you so much, young lady.
Yes.
Yes.
So
So we have, in the back of the cafeteria, there's a vegetable tray, pepperoni. You could go in the refrigerator, there's drinks. We're gonna roll Amanda's video my brother made for us to enjoy. You can eat in the sanctuary if there's not enough room back there, then just mingle. And if you guys have any stories you wanna share, you know, amongst each other, now's the time. So thank you. Thank you for coming. We really appreciate it. Stephen shares. I have so many friends here have traveled far. Ken, Andy, and all of yous. But my wife has touched people. None of us are perfect. But, you know, through faith, by grace, we are saved and renewed. And that's what gives me the strength to go on. And just thank you for coming. I appreciate it. My family appreciates it. Thanks.
Here for you, buddy.
Yeah. I'll put the BS on that. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not what we have done and what we do. It's what Jesus did on that cross 2,000 years ago. That's what makes it all possible, a man to do it. And we need to know it too. Amen. Every one of us. Call in the name of the Lord. And we're all going to be there. And all God's people said amen.
Amen.
I'm trying to.